see that fire? Oh yes.
Okay. Sa video na to, kakain tayo ng kebab. Pero bago yun, mapapalaban muna tayo ng English.
Good morning mga katropa. Nandito tayo sa office namin holiday ngayon. Meron silang celebration. So ito, meron kaming tent. Yan. Mamaya maglalagay kami ng something dyan. Pakita ko sa inyo. Ito mga tropa, nakakita ko ng ano, isang pan na ganyan. Gagawa kami ng roti. Yan mga katropa, yung roti kanina sinasabi, tinakpanan nila, pinapalsa. Ano daw to? Ito yung naan. So masarap to, mamaya testingin natin ha. Pakita natin sa inyo mamaya. Yan mga katropa, ito na yung ating naan. Nikot-ikot na niya. Hop! Lagay doon. Luluto. Yeah. Very nice roti.
Nice roti.
Yeah. Yan mga tropa, may nakita tayong ano, nagagawa sila ng raita. Usually kapag ka meron kang biryani, meron kang mga ganyan. So naglagay na sila ng kanin kanina, nakita ko.
Yeah. Vegetable biryani.
Vegetable biryani. Mag-interview tayo. Sir, tell me,
what is Dasara? Dasara is it's a festival.
What kind of festival?
That is, there is a 9 days.
9 days festival.
Yeah.
What they do?
They will puja for Amavaru. That is Lakshmi Devi. Lakshmi Devi, Saraswati. The Amavaru will in 9 types. Every day, one type of puja.
Okay. So, medyo binasa ko na rin yun, no? They will do puja every night for 9 days. Yeah. Celebrating the triumph of...
In different ways.
Celebrating the triumph of Rama for killing the 10-headed demon. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, mga tropa, nag-start na yung kanilang puja. Nasa labas kami ng gate. Ayun yung pinaka monk nila, yung priest, no? Yung nagsasalita na yon. Yan. So magi-ritual sila. Mamaya titingnan natin kung ano ang gagawin natin. Yeah, mga katropa. As you can see, he is waving the pumpkin. It is used to ward off evil. Just like jack-o'-lanterns in Ireland to ward off the soul of Jack, here pumpkins are used to ward off the evil eye. Traditionally, they used to sacrifice animals, but now they are using fruits, most commonly the coconut. But during Dasara, they use the pumpkins. Boom! Yan na mga katropa, pumapasok na sila after basagin yung ating kalabasa. Eh, nag-aapoy-apoy pa. So, tutuloy natin yung ating puja dun sa loob. Dun sa... Ayan mga tropa, nag-ano na sila. Nagpupuja na sila. Parang nasa loob yung pinaka main family. Tapos, andito sa labas yung mga guests, no? Okay, so try nating mag-interview ng konti. Okay mga tropa, habang nandito kami sa labas, try kong mag-interview, tanongin natin kung ano yung Dasara sa kanila. So pare, earlier I was with the Viswanatha Reddy. He told me this is a 9-day puja, and on the 10th day we celebrate the main puja. So tell me what is our
celebration.
Yeah, it is a long story, but I will tell you in a short.
Okay.
So it is the victory of Rama over Ravana.
Okay.
So who kidnapped Rama's wife Sita?
So Ravana kidnapped wife Sita.
Rama's wife Sita.
Rama's wife Sita. Okay.
So in this particular day, so he defeated Ravana, so that we celebrate as a victory, symbol of victory.
Ah, okay, okay. And then on those 9 days before this 10th day, what are we doing?
So we pray God says, our God says, Durga. So she's in different farms, okay? For 9 days, we pray for each farm.
On the farms? For harvest?
Harvest, everything. And everything. Like Annapurna for the food, for the evil, Saraswati for the studies, everything. For 9 days, there is a different goddess. So they decorate the goddess in a different forms. So the 10th day, it is the Vijayadashmi. So this is the final day, end of the day.
Okay, so ito na yung 10th day. So sabi nga niya, yung natalo na ni Rama, yung kumidnap sa asawa niya. So para mabigyan kayo ng konting background, si Rama yung isa sa mga pinakasikat na Hindu god, no? So pag binanggit mo siya, para siyang kumbaga sa atin, kilala mo si Thor. Norse god siya, pero siya yung pinakasikat halos. So parang ganun si Rama, ganun siya kasikat dito. Okay? So maya ulit ha. Ayan mga tropa, pumapasok na yung mga tao. Tapos na yung ating puja, pipila na sila dun sa kainan. So papasok na rin tayo para makita natin kung ano yung food sa loob.
Ayan mga tropa, merong french fries at saka bhaji. Yung roti kanina. Ayan. Hingi ako ng dinakot na, di ba? Hingi tayo. What's that, pare?
Sweet.
Sweet. Roti. Yeah. Bhaji. Okay. Muna yung plato natin, dumadami. Oh, ano yun? Gulab jamun? Okay.
Okay mga katropa, nakakuha na tayo ng Say hello. Ayan, tayo mga audience. Ayan. Okay? So, reviewin lang natin yung pagkain natin. Ayan, yung pinuha natin. Kunain natin yung french fries nila para malaman natin kung ano pinagkaiba sa french fries natin, no? Medyo weird na konti. Hindi ba weird? Hindi. Para sa yung french fries na Indian yung masala. Literal na ganun. So, ganun lang naman ang french fries, di ba? So, may nakita ako, na-try na kasi natin tong bhaji, no? So, wag na to. Yung papad lang nila, testingin natin. Kung iba ba dun sa papad na kinakain natin. Tsaka yung curry nila, alam natin kung ano to. So, testing ha? Mushroom curry. Sobrang anghang. Nandun na tayo ulit sa medyo matapang yung flavors nila, no? Dito sa Hyderabad. Matapang, may konting asim, may cream ako na lasahan, creamy yung naglagay sila ng siguro something na cream and yogurt. Ayan. Okay naman. Walang coconut. More on the feeling ko yung lasa niya. Merong konting butter, konti. Tapos meron lang yung cream niya. Subukan natin 'to. Ito. Fried tawag ito, okra. Fried okra with mani. Medyo kakaiba. Kasi dry siya, dry yung food niya, pinirito mo, kaso slimy yung ano, yung okra. So, for me, hindi ko nagustuhan masyado. Hindi ko gusto yung texture niya, no? Para sa akin, kung mag-slimy ako na okra, lalagay ko sa kanin na lang. Hindi sa ganito. Tapos, may nakita tayo, yung kanina yung nakita natin yung alwam. So, sinerve na sa atin. Testing lang natin para lang malaman nyo kung anong lasa. Ayan. Tastes better than it looks, no? May cashew, matamis. Parang yung sauce ng leche flan. Tapos parang may coconut flavor. So more on na hindi matamis na bukayo, yung medyo mas babaan mo yung tamis. Nandoon siya sa mas matamis ng konti sa leche flan. So masarap pala siya, para siyang yun nga, yung bukayo mo, tapos lagyan mo ng cashews, no? Okay, okay naman siya. Okay, so paano? Maya ulit, hanap ulit tayo mamaya ng makakain natin, ha?
Okay mga katropa, binigyan tayo ng giveaways. Binigyan tayo ng miracle jar. Tingnan natin kung ano itsura. Yan, jar. Tapos, binigyan tayo ng sweets. Buksan natin mamaya sa bahay. Tapos binigyan tayo ng ano to? Lutuan set. Kaya mamaya sa bahay na lang buksan natin. Ayan mga katropa, yung laman ng ating sweets. Binuksan ko na para makita natin. So okay naman, mukha namang masarap. Yung iba mukhang okay lang, no? Ayan. Tapos ito yung ating lutuan. Merong pre-lutuan. Okay, sige, pwede. Sige, paano? Lalabas pa kami. Tapos, mag-video ulit tayo. Titikman ko to. Mukhang masarap to. Okay, sige. Driving into the sunset. Papunta kami ngayon sa Old City. Maraming ganyan, no? So, mamaya, pagdating natin sa Old City, videoan natin kung anong makikita natin. And then, tingnan natin kung anong makakain natin doon, okay? Okay mga katropa, we are now in Hunar Mahotsav Exhibit. So, exhibit here means it's a Changge. So, since we had an interview this morning, we'll go English version today, okay? So that our foreigner friends can relate to us. So we will see what their Tiangge looks like. See? Oh, there. Sa Tiangge. So I will look for some interesting stuff. Maybe some clothes or some handcrafts. Then we'll see the food. If we can see some street food, we'll try it out, okay? As a walk around, we'll see something interesting. Oh, it's a tree. Oh, it's a peacock. Ah, very nice. This one, no? Look. Actually, they're very good in making handcrafts, huh? I like this. Some ceramic bowls and plates. See? A little bit difficult to bring back to Philippines, but nice if you have a house here. There. If we have red carpet there, we have a purple carpet here. See some statues and a fountain, and then this guy. With the buffalo. Yeah. Lions. Photo? Yeah, sure, photo. Okay. We'll just go for a photo after this guy, okay? Okay, so I've been trying some shoals. Trying to check some shoals for my wife. But apparently they don't have a shorter length of these shoals. Since they have some frills on the bottom,
if you fold it, it's not nice to look at. So cannot get anything. I don't see any street foods. Most likely the traditional Indian wear, the sari, the kadi, and then the shawls, no? So we'll try to circle round. Then we'll see. Okay mga katropa, we are now in their old city, the start of their old city. So here, a lot of Muslim population, right? So here, you can find some halal meats. And I saw something earlier. Oh, here, I'll show you. Look at this. See that? Beef, 220 per kg. 220 means 150 peso for Philippines. See? Pork is more expensive. And mutton is 5 times the price, ha? So here, old town means downtown. It's not like it means old. It means that's the term, downtown. No other term for it. It looks like recto, maybe? Something like that. Okay. Once we arrive at the Charminar, we'll try to see what they have over there. It's like a divisoria for us. Okay? Okay mga tropa, we are now in Charminar. If you can see this is the Charminar. It's like the symbol of love. It's like a Taj Mahal of Hyderabad. So you can see it's like a divisoria. There's many tiangues. And on the other side, there will be some food and big shops. So we're going inside the tiangues and we'll go inside, okay?
Okay mga katropa, we are just in front of the Charminar love symbol, no? It's very crowded, as you can see. So many crowd. And it's a little bit difficult to walk. So this one, this Nimra Bakery is one of the tourist spots here. Yeah, you can get chais and biscuits. So now I'll try to find somewhere to eat. And probably outside we'll try to get some ice cream. Okay? So it's a little bit to get a video there. So probably no video until I get the place I want to eat. Okay? Okay, so I just found some chicken, no? Chicken in the stick, this one. So I will try it and give you an update. Yeah, we'll try that this chicken. Nice. It's like eating a chicken cordon bleu. A little bit tangy, but texture is there. It's like our chicken cordon bleu in Philippines, huh? Mildly spiced. Not overwhelming. You can taste the lemon. Sour. Salty. Savory. It's nice. It's like a chicken barbecue, breaded chicken barbecue. It's nice, very nice. 10 rupees only. So 7 pesos. Okay? We'll try to look for more. I'll see you later.
So, we saw a parade. So, finally found it. A little bit difficult to find. It's just under the arch, no? Exactly under the arch. So we're going to Kebab I Jahangiri. So I ordered some kebabs. Right now they only have these three, this kind. So I got some paratha and a sikh kebab. We'll take a review of it. Whoa, it's very nice. See that fire? Oh yes. Okay, we'll try it. Here mga tropa,
our Sikh kebab. They only have one kind today. It's only beef, so it's okay. At least we got to try. In India, basically there's only 9 states who allow beef. So apparently, Hyderabad is one of them, and Bangalore is one of them. So this is their store. See that? See that fire? The smoke? So we'll try to review it, okay? So I got a little lost trying to look for this store, so you can see all the sweat, no? So here's the Sikh kebab. It's around 40 rupees each. So we'll try it and then we'll see. It's a little bit salty, but behind that saltiness, that savory flavor, no? There's this rich flavor. It's not overpowering like the other masalas we're having. This is more like a Middle Eastern style, not spicy, it's fresh, no? Let's try this with the green one. Green sauce. Maybe it's mint. Try it. It's very nice. It's ground beef, ground meat, no? So I've tried the chicken before. This one, the first time I tried beef here. This is very nice. Highly recommend when you go to Charminar, no? Try to Google the best kebabs, okay? So you'll have a wide variety. I don't know why now it's only this available, but they have mutton, they have chicken, they have a lot of things, no? So I got invited by the kind guys of the kebab Izangari, no? So they're very nice people. So when you go here, I definitely recommend you go visit them. And the kebab is very nice.
Thank you.
Okay.
That is James saying goodnight. Please like and subscribe.
So mga tropa, we had this mulberry rubbery here in Milan Juice Center. So it's one of the places you have to visit if you go here in Charminar. Okay? So let's try it. So this is our mulberry rubbery. Very nice. This is very nice dessert. It's creamy. It's fruity because of the mulberry. It's very nice actually. It's not too sweet. It's not overpowering your palate. You can eat a lot of it. Sometimes if it's too sweet, you can only eat a little bit, right? So this one is not like that. You can eat this whole, okay? So that's it. That's my pahabol. Okay, we're going back now. It's very tiring. Okay, night.